Friends, welcome. What is happening today? This is first in a series of webinar. We have had a last webinar on BAO, BEST, and the basic high level thing. This is a and we have lots of questions. What is the difference? How does it work? So on and so forth. And this is how we plan to do it. In sequence, the user management part, the risk management part, the installation and dealer front-end operations part, and mobile app working and features. BSC, we have Balaji, Kailash, and Rajesh ji. Usually, kisi ke naam ka ki ji lagata, lekin aapka naam Balaji ji ho jayega. It becomes a bit of a tongue twister. So, over to team BAO, if I can say. No best today, only BAO.
Yeah. Good afternoon to everyone. My name is Balaji. We have been doing series of webinars. Last week, we have been having high-level webinars. So this week, we wanted to take in-depth of the product in terms of what is the product offering.
Good evening, everyone. So I will give you a demo, a small part of risk management, user management, and dealer management in today's session. Okay. So initially, as it is scheduled, so we will start with the user management first in this session. So right now I logged in with one dummy internal users T1057. So every admin, every member admin will have this kind of users which append with the T and followed with a member ID as a member admin for every broker. Okay. I've already logged into the EXE. EXE part I will show you in details afterward. But initially, I will start with an admin menu first. So in admin, there are three things to be managed. Like first one is the user management. User management will comes into the creation of the user, creation of the. This is the user screen. Basically, the creation of the user, this screen has been followed up. So first, I will show you how to create and one user. Okay. So I will click on add button. I will click. So in BAO, every application or user should have some owner. So say suppose I'm taking owner as a member admin only. This can be also your branch. This can be also your HO admin or many other admin. This kind of thing. So I've selected T1057 as a user. I'm creating a user with name Amaya. AMEYA. Okay, I'll keep the status as active. These are the types of the users. Basically, user is an end user who it can be a client. It is a client. So the end user should be termed as a user. If anybody users want to create a member, want to create an employee, they can create as an employee also. So first, I will show you as a user first, as a creation of user. I will give them password. Default password you can give as per your requirement. So I'm giving some password right now to all users. So there are three types of password, password, mobile password, and transaction password. So same password, I normally keep the same password for all. Default thing is like a user need to keep first name as first name, last name. The mobile number will be needed to keep it. So I will give some mobile number. So no mobile number is necessary to be given as the mobile OTP SMS will be sent directly to this mobile number. Even we also try to get the email ID of the users. So if the mobile OTP is not reached to the mobile number, at least it should be reached to the email ID. So we say that email ID also is necessary to given. And I will give some PAN card number. So these basic information you have to provide. On the right hand side, you will find the permission, how the user can able to log in. So normally we give a thick client login. This is the thick client what we are logged in now with from. Thin client is a browser based and a mobile login also. So you can also give a user to log in through a mobile. So other permission like speculative users, give credit for delivery sales, this kind of permission you can able to give it up to the users. So I will tell you one by one what are there. allow trade modification is basic for the dealers or an RMS user to modify the trade in NSE exchange. Allow pro client is something where user is allowed to place a pro orders too. Speculative users where user can place an intraday orders also. Otherwise, you can restrict them client to place only for the delivery. If it is unticked, the user will be restricted to place only the CNC order or delivery order. Institution dealers and institution clients are specifically completely different product, so that can be taken up later. Some other permissions like allow only current month contracts trading. So if user wants to restrict any user, member wants to restrict any user to place only the current month, not a far month contract. So you just need to tick on this. So it will be blocked to trade for the far month contracts. And post trading rights to the group, whatever the owner has the trading rights, same trading rights will be enforced to the trading rights on the group. But feasibly, this has not been recommended to the user. Trading rights, I will show you how can to be blocked. After that is block trading on M2M cutoff. We have a functionality where the user, if it's been reached, his M2M is been cut off up to a particular percentage level, you can block him for the further trading and he will be into the square off mode. So users can, a member can take action on the square off mode and liquidity position. That thing also you can able to do it. Don't check deposit. It is something like super user. If you want to have some super user, you can give it. Exclude from square off. We have an intraday products and a CNC product. In intraday product, normally all intraday positions get squared up by 315. If you want some of your clients and high individual clients that their position need not to be squared up, you just has to untick this one so that position will be not squared up for that particular user for whom the exclude from squared is in marked. So this you can give. Similar to the don't check user deposit, we also have don't check for the DP user. So any holdings which has been not uploaded, and you want that user to sell his holdings as a delivery, you can check this and allow the user to sell the holdings. Allow exchange alerts is something like alerts which is sent by the exchange for the user exchange limits and all that can be forwarded to the particular users. That can be done only for the cases of the dealers, I will suggest for currently. Disable SLB Pro own position. So even the user, end user can able to see a pro position of SLB holdings, SLB trades and all. So with this, you can able to see SLB trades, previous trades for adding it forward. On the right hand side, there are permission like check group margin. Check group margin is something like every owner's margin will be get checked along with the user. So if the owner doesn't have a sufficient margin, and user has a sufficient margin, even in that case, the orders of that particular user will be get blocked. So depending upon the risk management, you can able to take and take this, use this functionality. In equity, we give three types of margin basically. One is a VAR margin, other is a user margin, and second is the highest of both. So VAR margin is a file what we uploaded from our user can, member can check this to the user normally. And the VAR margin will be charged as per the exchange files. Apart from that, you have a user margin. So user, a member can also specify a limit margins to all contracts or all scripts according to his risk management. So every script can be have a different margin or as per the member risk management. So you can able to take on user spend margin also if it is needed, or you can have use any of highest both. If suppose VAR margin is 7% and user has defined 10% for a particular script, so in that case you can check use highest margin of both. So you have all three options. Normally we suggest to keep at the VAR margin. For other option like derivatives, commodities and currency, we have three types of other margins like user margin and what I told you earlier, user specific margin. User spend margin is something like portfolio best margin where it is been calculated based on the spend file uploaded on the from the back end and that margin will be charged based on the portfolio of the complete portfolio of the client. Like if he bought something Nifty current month contracts and he sold some Nifty next month, So hedge benefit, we will get user will get the hedge benefit and margin will be charged accordingly. Similar to user spend margin, we have user spend plus exposure also. The ELM will be charged extra apart from the spend margin. So normally we recommend to keep user spend plus exposure in this case. And I just have to click on save this button. Amaya is already in there. Okay, Amaya one, save. So I have created a user with name Amaya. So if I want to find Amaya in this user list, I just need to find the user and click on find. I can find this user created and I can edit him if required anything. In the next step, I will show you how the dealer NNFID need to be mapped. Before that, I will also show you how the employee will be created. With the quick run, I will show you how the employee will be created. Same option is to be set, E1057. Dealer 23 has given. Yeah, so I've created one user now. I will just keep him as an employee. I click on save. So I've created an employee first. Okay, so once you create an employee, you need to map NNFID for a particular employee. So the location ID has been very much needed for every employee and the end user to map an NNFID. So NNFID is basically a location ID to be set for a particular user. So how to set an NNFID is a simple. We have an NNF location button up over here. The screens get opened. I just need to find that dealer. This was a dealer I've created now. So while creating providing an NNFID, member need to always note that he should give a broker ID for a particular user. E1057 is a broker ID currently I'm using. My default trader ID for equity is 901. So show I give a 901 for exchange BAC. I'm giving an NNFID for equity. And segment all. So NNFID can be like pin code, his branch code, his trading terminal, vendor code, and program cuts comes automatically default. You just need to click on save. It will be get updated. So this entries get entered. So this is the way how you can give an NNFID for the dealer. Similar to the dealer NNFID, you can also give an NNFID for an end user who is placing an order via internet, just like an IBT user. So I will show you example of that also once. So I'm finding an Amaya user. I've selected user as broker 1057901, BSC, equity. All pin code will be all time one, branch code will be all time one, trader code will be all time one, and I click on save. So NNFID will be set for that particular user. In similar fashion, you can give for the other exchange also, like BSC, NSC, M6, and CDX. So in this case, you need to only keep the check like what broker ID need to be mentioned and trader ID need to be mentioned. So broker ID for NSE will be a NSE broker ID, and trader ID will be the user ID allocated by the exchange for a particular member for BAO in specific. So that trader ID need to be only mentioned in this application. properly. So if any mismatch in the trader ID and the combination, it will be resulting to the penalties and can have a problem ahead. So you need to be very particular and specific while giving an NFID to particular user and the dealer. After giving an NFID, we normally have to map any user created to particular dealer for his trading. So I will show you how when dealer is been mapped to that particular user. So I come to an admin server, employee user mapping. Here is functionality employee user mapping. So right now I've created one dealer, dealer 232. Okay. So this is the dealer I've created, and I'm trying to find how many records have been updated. So you can click on the find button. So currently no record has been updated. So I want to need a user to be mapped. So I find the user, or I will find it all. So C1 is a user currently with me. I just need to click on add, click on save. So this user will be mapped under the dealer 232105. So whenever the dealers log in and download the client masters, he will get C1 mapped under him. And whenever he takes an order in order panel, C1 will be automatically come into his drop-down list along with other clients also what he's been mapped. And he can place order for that particular user. So this is the way how to employee users need to be mapped. So after that, I will come on one basic functionality of IP address mapping. This is basically member can restrict a dealer to log in from specific IPs only. Say like branch member has a branch and branch has a specific list of the IPs. So if you want you dealers to be restricted to log in only from that particular IP, he can able to do that. So suppose I've created one dealer now, dealer 232. So I will give an IP restriction, like say suppose any member has an IP like 10.228.23.0 till 10.228.23.225. So between this range only the user can able to log in. So if the member has a branch with IPs of such list, you can set the limit range of the IPs, and user can be log into this particular user only. Such user. I click on see. So this dealer can be logged in only from this specific user ID. So this is basically for the user management.